We're excited to be joined by reporter for the New Jersey Devils, Amanda Stein. You got all the scoops. You also, by the way, have the best handwriting in all of professional hockey.
Thank you. Which,
if you don't know, follow her on Twitter. You can see it. So you are in the midst of camp, and I just want to first ask you, what's the overall feeling in New Jersey as things really start to get going here?
You know what? It's just really exciting right now because there was so much success on an individual level with a lot of these players last year, whether it was Sharon Govich, Kuokkanen, Jack Hughes' success. So it's really exciting to be at this point where let's see what that success was last year and how it can translate this year. There's a lot of changes with the team with the addition of Dougie Hamilton coming in, Ryan Graves. And then, you know, players that you guys will be really familiar with in, you know, Dawson Mercer and Alexander Holtz. These are all players who are trying to make a push for a spot in the lineup. And so there's just a lot of excitement. I think also just to be back in an ordinary scenario where there are less restrictions, you can sort of move around the building a lot easier. So it's been really great. I think everyone's just been really anxious to get back to this.
So you touched on a few of them, but I was wondering if you could maybe give us what you think is the biggest storyline or the most important storyline heading into the new season.
Oh, man. I mean, there are definitely a couple, but I would say one of the most important storylines is just making sure that, you know, this team can, I don't want to say rekindle what was there last year, but take the next step. And what Tom Fitzgerald, general manager of the Devils, often talked about last year was the idea of using last year when it was just a completely different scenario to look under the hood of the car, as he called it, where you're seeing what pieces you have, who's part of your engine. And we did see that last year. We saw some of those bright lights come up with, as I mentioned before, Kuokkanen and Sharon Govich, and the list kind of goes on and on. Jesper Bratt taking a new step, same with Pavel Zacha. So this year is really about, you know, I was talking to Tom Fitzgerald, it's about, okay, you've got these pieces of the engine. Can they make the engine go now? We have to see this year a step in the right direction, that when we're down the stretch, you know, towards the end of the playoffs, the Devils need to be in the mix because that's the next step here.
No doubt about it. And to keep the car theme going, perhaps the driver, if you will, is Lindy Ruff. He's the man that's going to put this team on the ice, and they're going to play the style that he wants them to play. You saw it firsthand last year. Give us an idea of what a Lindy Ruff team is supposed to play like. What kind of game they're going to show the NHL night in, night out?
So it's a game of pace, but it's a game of responsibility. And it's responsibility first. And when you're responsible, the pace creates itself. And I know that's sort of convoluted and sort of, you know, goes hand in hand, but really, he really preaches accountability. And that's the most important thing. If you are not playing well, you will not get the ice time. He will reward you for that. So if you are playing within his system, which again is about being responsible and knowing what your, you know, specific task is, you will get rewarded with that ice time. So for me, what I'm really looking forward to this year mostly actually is watching this team have practice time. Because in Lindy Ruff's first year, which was last year, we really didn't have any practice time. I think we went almost like 6 weeks without a practice because we were shut down because of COVID. So our schedule got condensed even more. And so I think this is going to be an opportunity for Lindy Ruff to even implement even more what his systems are and the expectations that he has.
Finally, with the depth that the Devils are coming into camp with, there's going to be significant competition for roster spots. And I have to think, and maybe you do too, this benefits the entirety of the organization.
So it does, right? And you're absolutely right. You know, having internal competition, you know, we say it sometimes like as just sort of off the, you know, as something that is normal, but it's not always normal. You don't always have that internal competition. So bringing in someone like Dougie Hamilton, for example, really forces everyone else on the defensive side to play their very best. And it goes back to what Lindy Ruff says, or what I said Lindy Ruff says. It's, you know, you have to be your best. You have to earn your ice time. So if Dougie Hamilton is an elite defenseman and he comes in and he's playing really well, well, that's a spot that's no longer going to be there for someone else. So it really forces everybody to be at their very best at every single moment, whether it's practice or in a game or what have you. So I think that's something that's really important that's been created over the last year, or the offseason, I should say, is this internal competition. We'll continue to push this team and individual players to be at their very best.
I'm not sure anybody has better insight in the Devils than you do. I want to thank you for taking the time to talk to us, and we'll be bothering you throughout the season.
My pleasure. It's never a bother. It's never a bother. I'm happy to do it.
Thanks, Amanda.